Dr. Greger recently discussed an extremely powerful spice that can help to fight pain at tiny doses. This spice can be bought fresh or dried, and we're going to learn why the dried version is way more effective at reducing inflammation and reducing pain. So let's take a listen first to that clip, and then we'll come back and look at the remarkable things that happen if we up the dose to 1 teaspoon a day.
You know, so there's all these experiments showing all these amazing benefits of dried ginger, including, I'm sure they'll be featured in my next major book, How Not to Hurt, talking about natural approaches to pain management. Because ginger, even a small amount, like 1/4 teaspoon ginger, does also thing in terms of decreasing painful periods and osteoarthritis and all sorts of really cool stuff. Anyway, and so the reason they used powdered ginger is because they wanted to hide it in capsules to pit it against placebo. And they even dust the little ginger powder on the placebo capsule so they both smell like ginger, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so you don't know. Are you taking real ginger? You're not. And then, so the benefits are not just the placebo effect because you've kind of subtracted the placebo effect, and it's actually the ginger. Okay, so that's how you do really robust studies, but wouldn't fresh ginger even be better, right? Actually, we think one of the primary compounds, at least for pain killing, and anti-inflammation are these shojils, which are dehydration products of the gingerol, that spicy ginger flavor smell compound. So it's actually not, those shojils are actually not found in fresh ginger, only found in dried ginger. And that may be why, in studies on weight loss, for example, you give people fresh ginger, they don't lose any weight. Over control, but you give people dried ginger and you can get them to lose weight because there's different compounds in it.
This is a fascinating randomized double-blind placebo-controlled study where researchers gave participants a teaspoon of ginger a day or placebo for 12 weeks. But they also told both groups to limit their dietary cholesterol intake and to increase their fiber and get more exercise. So we would expect even the placebo group to improve. But here's where it gets interesting. The ginger group had really impressive results. The scientists found that daily consumption of just 1 teaspoon of ground ginger a day resulted in a significant decrease in inflammatory marker levels and improvements in liver function tests and a drop in liver fat. As Dr. Greger mentioned, some of ginger's most impressive benefits might be its ability to fight pain. There have been 8 randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trials of ginger for pain, everything from migraines, painful period cramps, osteoarthritis, to irritable bowel. This remarkable review, where researchers found that up to 2 grams of ginger a day, spread out into 2 or 3 doses, was found to be just as effective as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen against extreme pain like menstrual cramps. Next, we'll look at what 1 teaspoon of ginger did to cancer cells. To view that video, you can click the center of the screen now.